Thanks everybody for coming. It's really exciting to see you all here. For those who don't know me, I'm Jared, half of the school. Jasmine is the other half. And a little bit of the background for some of you. I travel and teach woodworking and happened to land in Japan a few years ago and in Sweden and met Masashi. And through the course of a few years of traveling over there, starting this school, pandemic, we got this class together. So we invited Kotaro and Shuko to come teach a class on how to carve spoons with a special plane, a hand spoke shape. The one he was using just a little while ago. So that class happened this past weekend. People from all over the country showed up, which is really exciting. And so it's also nice to see you all in the local community here checking out what we got going on. So hopefully you'll spread the word. And I'd just like to introduce Kotaro Okubo, Shuko, and Masashi. Kotaro's going to do a little demonstration, and then Masashi's going to do a little talk on his work. And there's a pop-up gallery, so Kotaro's work is for sale, support craft. And we'll be hanging out for a little while. We'll have a little reception afterward. So I hope you enjoy. Thanks for coming.
Hello everyone, my name is Kotaro Okubo. I'm from Japan. 日本語ですいません。日本から、の長野県からやってきました大久保孝太郎と言います。普段、こういう今回南京ガンナっていう私が一番、得意とする道具をアメリカの皆さんにも紹介しちゃって今回こうワークショップを作らせてもらって。今日はそんな自分たちの、今まで日本でやっていくこと、それと今に至るまでの自分のこのキャリアなんかを紹介したいと思います。どうぞよろしくお願いします。
Okay, hello everybody. His name is Kotaro Okubo. He is from Nagano Prefecture, which is the central part of Japan. And he specializes in the particular Nankin Ganda.Kind of spoke shape. He's been developing this tool for 10 years, carving spoons and spatulas. So he wanted to introduce this tool to American woodworking community. And because Jarrod invited him, we came over from Japan and for the class last weekend. So from now, he's going to talk about his.
Hello, I'm Shuko. worker, good worker.
And I am Drag.
Ah, blacksmith. From local. From local. She's been running the shop for 8 years.
This fork shape, Nanking Gana, we had block plane from long time from long time ago, but
about this spoke shape, it said that it was imported to Japan. The Western style spoke shape was imported to Japan when we started importing chairs. So there are woodworkers who repair or who make new chairs from about 150 years ago, and they somehow combined Japanese traditional block plane and Western style spoke shape, and they made this particular type of Japanese nanking. Kanna is a hand plane. And and since then, this tool was used for rather rough work to shape the crest or spindles or stretchers of the chair. And it wasn't a fine tool. So he has been developing this tool from rough tool to very fine tool. And now he is happy about the quality of the tool. So that spatula blank he brought it from Japan, and he soaked it in water for a couple of days before he started carving. He normally does that. He buys in sawn timber, sawn lumber, and cut out the spatula or spoon blanks with bandsaw, and then soak them in water for a couple of days, and then carve. And the lumber is about milled about a year ago, so it's quite new. Ideally, he realized that at first he used to use the air-dried wood, and he realized that it makes more sense if you are using hand tool to use the green. So he's ideally you can use log and clear it and make a green spoon or spatula blank. But because he carves 6,000 pieces every year, he doesn't have time to cleave and bandsaw them, each of them. So instead he buys in lumber, and then he bandsaw them. So 500 pieces every month,
テレビマンについて何かちょっと聞い
てる？あ、そうですね。うん、こちらはあの日本では削り馬って呼んでます。あの後からそのグリーンとワークの人たちが使っているものがシェービングホースだと聞いて、あの日本もあの外国の人もみんなこれのことを馬って呼んでるんだなと、ちょっと面白くて、うん、これも自分で作ります。あのシェービングホースと違って足で踏み込んで、これはあの下にこうゴムのバンドでこう引っ張り上げて戻る、そういう機構になってます。これのいいところはこう手前も削れるし奥も削れる、それからこう立てたり、これをこうフェンスに使ったりとか、そんなこういろんな場所が使えるので、この自分の仕事に非常に適した馬だと思います。で今回あの飛行機乗れるようにこちらも非常に簡単に組み立てられる形になっていて、スーツケースに入るんです。なんであの世界中どこでも削れる馬になります。
家ではもうちょっと大きいんですか？
そうですね、家ではもうちょっと大きいの使ってます。
And he brought this shape horse from his home. At home he uses a little larger shaving horse. And he designed and made by himself. In Japan we call it kezuri-uma. Kezuri-uma. Uma is horse. Kezuri is shape. So shaving horse. And he designed and made this one so that he can take it apart and put it into the suitcase, because he sometimes travels and does some demonstration at the exhibition.
そうだね。年に数回あの日本国内で展だったり出展するんですけど、その時もこれを必ず持っていって、自分の作ってるものがどうやってできているのかっていうのを目の前で見てもらう。で、それこそはあの製品を持った時にあの使ってくれる人がそのものの背景を知ってくれる一番の材料に説得力になるんじゃないかなと思って、あのいつもこれに乗って全国歩いてます。
So when he does the exhibition in the big city like Tokyo or Osaka, he always takes the shaving horse with him, and he does demonstration in front of the client. He wants to show how his work keeps his work going. He wants the customer to know not only the quality of the products, but also the skill behind it. If there's any question, please.
そうですね、あの今完成品も並んでるんですけど、形に応じて私はあのそれにあのフィットしたあのセッティングの軟筋ガンダムを作ってます。それとあと今この鍛冶屋と一緒に協力してより良い軟筋ガンダムを作ろうっていうのも同時に研究してます。なのでそれをこう進めるためにもあの1年に今その去年は多分30本ぐらい新しいものを作っていろいろ試したがら、あの今まさにこう進化させて真っ最中。
違う鍛冶屋さんに違う刃を作るま
で。そうですね、あの日本の鍛冶屋もこれが作れる鍛冶屋はそんなに多くない。なのでご縁があった人に来週つく、って感じですね。
Yes, each are different. Like,
for example,
the width and the shape of the sole, the bottom, are different. So he choose each nankin gana according to
the curve of the workpiece.
How many does he have?
今は何個持って
るか。今は
多分300ぐらい。
全部で。In total, 300.
Okay.
he asked the blacksmith to make the blade. He asked several blacksmiths to make blades with different material.A different steel, because he wants to explore the quality of shaving, and also he wants to support the blacksmith, so he gives them the job, and then he carves the handles himself. So last year he made 30 nagira.
アジアはやっぱりカンナの方を作るプロなんですけど、カンナを使うプロではない、うん、なので、カンナを使うのは自分の方が得意です。うん、だから、鍛冶屋には得意な鍛冶屋で最高の刃を作ってもらう。で、それを自分は最高の腕で持って使って、でその感想を鍛冶屋に返す、うん。それをこう繰り返すことで、この刃を向上させていこう。そういうことを取り組みます。
So he always likes toCollaborate with blacksmith and develop a tool with them. So he always asks something new, like use this steel or width or thickness. But they are not specialists of using tools.They are the specialist of making tools, but he is the specialist of using those tools. So as soon as he got the blade, he carved the handle to fit, then use them for some time and give them the feedback and ask them to develop them.
Is wood a hard resource to purchase as far as with this demand? Is it hard to find the cherry and different kinds of wood that he's looking for?
材料は手に入りにくいですか？
いや、私の材料を選ぶ一番基準が手に入りやすいことですね。日本国内の今長野県という場所でやっていて、その地域で入手が簡単なこと、それとも値段もそんなに高くない。そして使用っていうふうになってるので、それを基準に木を選びます。
使用っていうのは硬さであったり、
そうですね、強度だったり、熱に強いとか、水に強いとか、あと漆の重みだとか、使い口に含むのに舌触りがいいように、乾燥剤とか、散光剤とか、用途に応じて決めます。
So, he chose the material.Available. The most important thing for him to choose the material is the availability locally. So he uses cherry, chestnut, walnut, maple. They are available in his area. And also he chooses the material according to its purposes, durability to water or.Enough strength for stirring, or enough good density, smooth enough in your mouth for spoons. Open ring porosity is not good for spoons. Something like that. Denser wood is better for spoons.But anyway, so the availability, the wood is available.
Will he be bringing wood back from Wisconsin to Japan? Did he find some wood here to bring back home to carve?
Yes.
Joy. Which wood?
Joy brought some beautiful black walnut.
Ah.
Mm, so one of his suitcases will be filled with black walnut.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Okay. So
finish.
So as far as done.
What other woods would you bring?
Sorry?
What other woods would you bring from the United States?
What other woods might he take back to Japan?
Spanish.
Other woods other than the walnut? Was there anything else he was interested in taking back
with him? Ah, what else would he
take
back?
うん。そうですね。そうだね。やっぱり日本では出会うことはない。気には非常に興味があります。Yeah,
he's interested in some species which we don't have. For example, black walnut. We don't have black walnut. We have Japanese walnut.
その一つ例を挙げるとしたら、ブラックウォーナットに関しては日本国内で受精してないですよ。だから我々もこう日本の国の非常に、黒い木が日本では比較的珍しいですね。だから非常に人気があって、そして非常に高い。So
yeah, in Japan, dark wood is rare.
There's no rules on how many he sharpens or how many how often sharpens, but he wants to keep the quality of the blade for carving. He wants to keep as same as possible so that he can keep working. For example, he carves one spoon in 20 minutes, and he uses he doesn't sharpen while he's carving, but after he finishes one spoon, he sharpens both. So it means he sharpens two blades every 20 minutes. Blacksmith to use the steel, which is hard.
How does that work?
Thank you.
So since then, he kept working for drillers. I don't know. They work on old temples and houses, but also they do some work for shop. So not only working with solid wood, they use plywood to make some shop furniture.
Sliding screen or sliding door for traditional Japanese houses.
cultural property by the national government. So those buildings have to be kept as it is, and they regularly have to be maintained using the original material and the original technique. So that also helped him to learn traditional skills or hand tools.
Students can come and learn how to use hand tools and how
juice. It's kind of tannin to prevent the wood from rotting or decaying. Kitchen. Persimmon. It is a juice, a fruit.
Plate for bread. At that time,
buying woods.
Is the work
workshop right close there, or does he
So this is the scenery from the kitchen of their house.
これは続きは午後からの景色ですね。朝日なんですけど、毎日朝早いんで、今の時間だったら5時ぐらいに日の出が来るので、毎朝日の出と夕日を見ながら過ごしてます。So
that's the scenery from his workshop, 5 o'clock in the morning. Because he started working at 4, he always see the sun rise and sunset from his workshop.
非常にこう四季を感じながら、毎日こう静かな場所で削ってますね。
So the whole season is beautiful.
これ昨日のワークショップ。先日3日間のワークショップに参加していただいた最終日の集合写真なんですけど、 先ほど見てもらったランキンガンナの、マスター仕様という、3日間のワークショップをさせてもらいました。1日目にさっき見てもらった木の実を、2日目はこちらになるスプーンを大久保式で使ってもらって、3日目は特殊を兼ねながら自由に作ってもらって、そんな3日間を過ごしてました。
Until the class started, he was so nervous or worried if he could teach well or if the students could use the tools well or if they could sharpen well. But he was so impressed that all the students were so focused and passionate, and they asked so many questions. And each question reminded him of his early days, because he wasn't good at tools, he wasn't good at sharpening, and he kind of overcame each of those troubles. So, so it was a very good experience. And then, so he started thinking of his future from now on. This experience must have, must change his real work somehow. So he's looking forward to it.
School and some of his work with blacksmiths in Japan.